Hello, hi Booknut family. Hello everyone. First of all, a very happy World Poetry Day to everyone here. Today is World Poetry Day, as everybody knows, and we wanted to celebrate this day in a special way with a special person, and what's a better way to celebrate it instead of having a conversation with somebody who loves poems, who loves words and emotions. So our today's guest is author Rebecca Wasson, the author of this amazing book, Voyage on the Tides of Emotion. So how is everyone doing? Which poetries are you reading? Please comment down. Let us know which poetries. I am in love with this book. I am in love with every poetry that's written here, all the different emotions, and I can't wait to talk to the author and discuss more about this book. So, which are the books that you are all are reading? Which are the poetries that have they are living rent-free in your head right now? Yes, hello, good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
Hello,
How
ma'am.
are
How
you
are you doing?
doing?
I'm
I'm
fine.
good.
How about you? Happy World Poetry Day.
Happy World Poetry Day to you.
So I was just telling everyone about you that so everybody this is author Rebecca Wasson, the author of this book, A Voyage on the Tides of Emotion, my new favorite book. I must say that I absolutely loved every poetry that you've written here. The way you spoke about all the different emotions, completely hooked to this book. So ma'am, would you like to introduce yourself to our audience?
Sure, yes, I'm Rebecca. I'm a college professor, college and university professor. I live here in Toronto, Canada. I am originally from India, of course. I'm from Madras, in India, but I've lived in Canada now for over 10 years. And this is my first book, although I've been writing poetry since I was 14 years old. And some of those old poems are actually in the book. But this is my first book, first published book.
Okay. Ma'am, I was really curious, when I saw the book, I was really curious about the title. So I would just like to ask you why the title of Voyage on the Tides of Emotions?
Because I think emotion is such a human thing, and we cannot be human, unless we are emoting. We're emoting all the time, and I just wanted it to be a universal book. I wanted it to have a universal appeal, and this book would make sense to anybody who reads it. I mean, the poetry is not very complex. I'm not a literature major. My poetry is from the heart, and it's pretty simple, and anybody can understand it, and anybody can relate to it. Whether you're a young person or an old person, whether you're in love or you've been in love or you want to be in love, you can relate to it because emotion is, that's what makes us human, right?
That's true. Ma'am, I would just like to, point out you have dedicated this book to your grandmother. As soon as I saw that line, I was like, that is the most sweetest thing ever. It's so beautiful. And as you mentioned that it is so relatable. It is very relatable. Starting from the very first poem, I don't want to spoil the audience. I want them to read it themselves. But when you just go through the poetry, you can feel it. You can feel those emotions. So it's beautifully written, ma'am. I just wanted to let you know that it's very beautifully written. And ma'am, can you tell the audience about your creative process? Because in this book, you have also, it's the poetry, the words, verses are accompanied by your own art. So can you tell the audience a little bit about that? Which one, if as an author, what would you prefer? You as a poet or you as an artist?
I think as a poet, because I've been writing poetry from a very young age, I started doing art since the pandemic, because I was at home. I needed something to do. I was working from home, And as with most people during the pandemic, it was really depressing to be at home. So I needed a creative outlet. And then my sister suggested this, digital art tool called Sketchbook. So I make digital art on that. And oddly enough, I never thought of putting my art to my poetry and correlating it. Many of the poems were written before, but strangely, when I decided to do the book, I found that many of my paintings could match with the poems that I've written. So that was how I did it. It was not like the art was done for the poetry or the poetry for the art. They were made at very different times, but they ended up being a good match for the book.
Yes, ma'am, they match perfectly. I could actually, I'm not an artist like as good as you are, but whenever I see any kind of painting or drawing, I quickly look for meaning into it, and I could see that. I could see the meaning in every poem that you had written, how beautifully it matched every sentence, the emotions and everything. It was just beautiful. Ma'am, you wrote about a lot of, emotions, as you've mentioned. There's fear, there's grief, there's love, there's hope, there's so many things. Which is that one particular emotion that you felt was the most challenging to write about? I'm very curious to know that.
I think unrequited love, you
Oh,
can't be a
yeah.
poet and be happy in love. There always has to be pain and suffering if you are to write poetry. So unrequited love possibly was the hardest to write about, but also, truly from the heart. Yes.
Loved this line that you just said, that you cannot be a poet without, unrequited love. It's just so beautiful. Just talking to you feels so, poetically. Your every sentence that comes out of your mouth is just so poetic. Okay. It's just so beautiful, ma'am. Also, I would also like to know, ma'am, you've touched on so many emotions. After writing the book, did your feelings change? Did your emotions evolve as a result of, writing this book?
Yes, I think it was cathartic in a way, to be able to put that into paper, and then you can see what you have gone through. And I think writing is a good way to sort of understand your emotions, become more self-aware, and also to heal from the traumas of the past. It sort of helps you when you can put it down on paper, and then you can. The bad things you try to let go of it, and the good things you hold on to it. I think writing can be very cathartic that way, and it was for me too.
That's beautiful. Bam, now, can I would like to just get to know more about you personally. So, were there any specific poets or any specific book, poetry book, poetry collection that you grew up reading to and that inspired you, that inspired your style of writing?
Well, I always loved the romantic poets, whether it's Wordsworth or Lord Byron, Walter Scott. These were some of the poets that have really inspired me. I've loved Maya Angelou. I've loved so many different poems and poets over the years, and I think they have influenced my book in many ways. I remember one of my favorite poems in school was Lochinvar by Sir Walter Scott, which is a poem about a medieval knight and how he saves the woman that he loves. He saves the damsel in distress. They don't want him to marry her, but then he carries her off. So very romantic, a very medieval romantic poem, and I think that influenced my writing of the poem Yearning. There's a poem called Yearning in the book, which is very You know, it has a very medieval theme of knights and ladies and lords and castles. So yeah, so I have been inspired over the years by many of the great poets, Shakespeare, of course. Yes, yeah.
So, ma'am, which is your favorite poem from your poetry collection then? That one
The
poem.
ones that I have written,
Yes.
well, they all have a piece of my heart in them. I think I love moments, the snow globe. I think
Oh.
that was something that it is a poem of unrequited love. But I think that has really, it has come, it is very close to my heart. Yeah. And I've
My
painted a snow globe
yeah.
for it. Yeah.
Which is beautiful. My favorite poetry is from the introspection section, the very first one, Split, the very first line. You know, sometimes I wonder who I am, demon goddess or virgin angel. That's it. This is the poetry for me. As soon as I read this, I think I've read this particular poem, I think 5 times or something, because it was just so beautiful for me. So, you know, relatable and so raw, just emotions flowing out. I kept reading this poem. I'm going to be honest about that. Ma'am, would you like to read any favorite line from one of your poetries? Like, we can do it together. Any favorite line?
Sure. What would you like me to read?
Ma'am, your favorite verse, anyone?
Okay, so from Moments, the snow globe, that is on page 7. They say we never remember days, only moments. Be that as it may, let me take those moments of warm sunshine and melting ice cream cones, of love poems and the music of guitars and night chats over the phone, and put them all away into my own little snow globe. So when the world turns cold and bitter and hard, I'll give my snow globe a spin and remember the warm days of love and the cool nights of passion, those old, old memories of being touched and wanted and cherished. When the skies turn gray and the cold winds howl around like wolves, I'll give my snow globe a spin and remember the warmth of friendship and the endless nights of chatter, the good food and the laughter and the fruity wines. When the years roll on in an endless tide and my hair turns white and my vision blurs, I'll give my snow globe a spin and remember the endless kisses and the sighs of love and Shakespeare verse, all mixed up in Monet colors. When the pain cripples and health fails and death comes calling, I'll give my snow globe a spin and remember you and me as we were, so young and free and so full of hope, so full of dreams, waiting for life to begin. I will remember. Yeah, that.
Oh. That's so beautiful. Hearing it from you just changes the, when I was reading it, I was like, okay, that's so beautiful. But hearing it from you is just amazing. It's, I can actually feel the emotions that you were trying to portray. It's beautiful, ma'am. Ma'am, there are a lot of aspiring poets and all. Is there any advice that you would like to give them, those who are planning to, you know, write their own poetry with their own artwork as well? Is there any kind of advice you'd like to give them?
I'll just say, just start writing, you know, because often we think that we don't know enough about writing, we don't know enough about poetry, and then you want to take a class on poetry, you want to take a class on creative writing. But I think, you know, classes are great. I did a certificate course on poetry as well from the Open University. But it doesn't really get you started on writing. For writing, you need to really just sit down and start. For me, I have a creative process for writing poetry. Sometimes, you know, it's very, sometimes it's very spur of the moment. It comes directly from emotion. But at times when I want to write, I turn on music. I turn on classical music, especially the piano or the violin, with music without words, just music, right? And then when I listen to it, I just close my eyes and listen. I can see pictures in my head. The music evokes images in my head, you know, of usually of, I'm an old soul, so usually of times past, knights and ladies, romantic images, you know, courtly scenes. I get all these images in my head, depending on the music that I'm listening to, and then it becomes easier for me to put that on paper or in art. So everybody would have their own creative process that way. So see what works for you. Just sit in a room quietly by yourself, turn off the mobile phone, turn off the TV, maybe turn on some music and just start writing. And it's okay, even if you hate what you write, even if you feel it's rubbish. I think all writers feel that way, but just keep writing. That's what you should do.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I would, you know, I loved this book so much. I just can't wait to, you know, read more of your works. Is there any, can we get any insights into your future projects, or are you planning to write any more? Can we just get to know a little bit about it? Because I cannot wait. I really need to read more of your poetry.
I have a children's book in the works, which I'm doing with my sister. My younger sister, Shauna, she's an artist, a real artist. You know, she's actually studied art. So she has made the illustrations, and the poem is mine. I wrote the poem when I was young. It's a poem called Fairies. It's about a fairy wedding. So she has done some beautiful illustrations for it, and we want to publish it together. It's a children's book. And the nice thing about it is we have a very inclusive idea for it. Many of the fairies, you know, you'll find fairies wearing saris, you'll find Indian looking fairies, you'll find Chinese fairies, you know, because usually in Western art and Western books, it's, you know, the fairies are all white and blonde and blue-eyed. But we have tried to be very inclusive and diverse in our book. So it should appeal to little children from all over the world, you know, because all children look different and they're all beautiful. And so that's a book that is in the works and it's coming up. Yeah. I'm sorry, that's my cat. She's upset because I'm not giving her attention. Yeah,
that's love.
I live
that's
with
love.
My cat. Yeah,
her name is Love, her right?
Her name is Love. Yes, she's right here in the book. She's very important for the creative process. Yes,
that's so sweet. Ma'am, before we end the session, would you, you know, give the audience a little bit of your poetry recommendations, which books they should be reading? Which book are you currently reading? Any poems?
Well, right now, I'm doing my PhD, so I'm not reading a lot of fiction. I'm still working on my dissertation, so there's a lot of reading that I have to do for my academic work. Unfortunately, my fiction reading is on hold for now. But people who want to get started on English poetry, I would say just start with Wordsworth and Keats and Coleridge, you know, the romantic poets. They are easy to read and they are beautiful. The imagery that they evoke, it's absolutely beautiful. Also, if you want to start with Shakespeare, you'll get overwhelmed if you read the big plays, but you can start with Shakespearean sonnets. The sonnets are just a few lines, you know, and they are beautiful. Shakespeare sonnets are absolutely beautiful. And yeah, just get lost in that imagery as you read it. And it's amazing. Yeah.
So just sit in a beautiful place with a beautiful setting, just open the book and just read it. Maybe light a scented candle, just feel the vibe and, you know, be in the moment.
Yeah. Yeah, be in the moment. I think that's so hard for us to do because of all the distractions of social media, and we get so distracted. And it's so hard for people to read these days that we are listening to audiobooks. But just be in the moment, yeah, and try to read. Yeah.
Luckily, thankfully, thanks to you, I was able to be in the moment when I was reading your book. I did the same thing. I just had a scented candle, some fairy lights, and I was just sitting in the room and reading the books and feeling all the emotions that you were portraying in your book. So thanks to you, I was able to, get out of my phone and how the way they say it, touch the grass, live in the moment. I lived in the moment because of your book. So thank you so much for that. So before we end the session, I would like to ask the audience if anybody has any questions that they would like to ask ma'am, if they want to discuss about any books, they want to share anything, please feel free to do so.
I think my family's here watching. It was nice having this chat with you. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
And I like the little videos that you did as well for the book.
You
You're a great model for books.
so much, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So, yes. There is a question from a book podcaster. What does Poetry Day mean to you?
A lot of people think poetry is very old-fashioned. Even when we try to get books published by publishers, a lot of times we hear, it's poetry, nobody really reads poetry. And you've got po poems from, a very famous poet now is Rupi Kaur. Rupi Kaur is an Indian poet. Again, I think she's based in Canada as well. And she writes poetry with illustrations, not colored illustrations, little doodles. But her poems are like, they're very short. They're maybe three or four lines. And it's become Instagram and TikTok has become a famous place for poetry now because they're very short poems, just two or three lines that people write. So, we hear publishers say that that's all people are interested in. They don't want to read traditional poetry. They don't want to read long poetry. But I disagree because I think as long as humanity lives, poetry is going to live. It's a very beautiful art form, and I think it's important to keep it alive because it is poetry, just as music or literature or art, it's one of those ways in which we can truly express what we feel. And I also feel it can bring the world together in many ways. I remember reading some poetry by children from war-torn areas, children living in Gaza, for instance, and in other places. And it was so touching. And I think it can really get people to connect. When you put it in poetry and when you read it, you can really really empathize, put yourself into the other person's shoes. So that's why I think Poetry Day is so important, and we should not let this die out, So keep buying poetry books, keep reading. Don't stick only to Instagram poetry. Instagram poetry is fine, I have nothing against it, but I think the traditional poetry forms and books should be preserved as well, and that's what, it's part of human culture and civilization, and that's so important.
Ma'am, as you mentioned about
Without
Instagram, I
Rupi,
just realized,
yeah.
yeah, there is this trending meme that's going on Instagram right now. They just say a normal sentence in English, and then they just say that in poetry it means this. So I would just like to tell the audience that, in English it is human emotions, but in poetry it's this book. It's this book in poetry. So, with that, is there any more questions? Anybody wants to ask anything? Everybody's just wishing us happy World Poetry Day. Happy World Poetry Day, Book Club family.
It's 8 o'clock in India now, is it? It's about 10 o'clock here in Canada. Yeah, and I have a class at 11 a.m. from home. Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so mom, then we would just like to end the session with that.
Okay.
Thank you so much
Thank
for
you so
joining
much.
us.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for the amazing book. It was my birthday a few days ago. I'm taking this as my birthday gift, the best birthday gift. Thank you
That's
so much for that.
awesome. Yeah, I hope you enjoy the poems and
Thank
split the one that you talked about. Yeah, that again, it's a beautiful poem, and I think it defines a woman all the time, because people either look at us as god, goddess, or the other extreme as a whore. A woman is looked at either way, and we are neither, and we are both together, right? And I think that's a great poem. So I'm so glad you got the book. So enjoy it.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank
Thank
you.
you. Thank you, everyone.
Bye.
Thank
Bye.
you. Bye.